My name is Angeli Dilibute.
It's Glendale Dilipon.
It's Alba Joyce Lisandra.
Martin Legaspi.
It's J. Marin Laysen. And we are your teacher for Arts 9. Today, join us as we become your tour guide and you, our students, will be exploring a museum. I know you are all excited, but before anything else, let's have a prayer for guidance and safety.
Sign of the cross, in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Spirit leads me where my trust is without borders. Let me walk upon the waters, wherever you would call me. Take me deeper than my feet could ever wander, and my feet will be made stronger in the presence of my Savior.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Exciting to witness a virtual tour of a museum? Right now, I'd like to take a minute to familiarize you with the area and discuss some brief rules and regulations. Each chamber will necessarily require your active participation and full attention. We want you to be persistent in your listening. As we enter the museum, we want you to explore and learn everything it has to offer. I guarantee you'll have a good time here at the museum. Alright, pack up your things, bring with you your bag, and don't forget to enjoy while learning. Now, let's have our activity entitled Movie Ticket, Ticket for Entry. Yes, you heard it right. You are going to watch movie clips, not just one, but two. It's about the fall of Roman Empire during 1964 and Helen of Troy from 1956. And after that, I will be asking you questions in order to have our entry ticket to the museum. Now, spare some time to watch and observe. Watching the fall of Roman Empire, it's time for you to watch and observe the movie Helen of Troy. Movie clips of the fall of Roman Empire and Helen of Troy. Are you all ready to have your entry ticket already? To get it, you need to answer these questions. What can you say about the movie clips, the fall of Roman Empire and Helen of Troy? Some of you answered that the characters involved from the movie clip, the Helen of Troy, are from Greece based on their actions, what they wear, and the structure of their place. It depicts history with classic jail structure, what happened, and how it looked back then. In the movie clip, The Fall of Roman Empire, the discovery of ancient Greek and Roman ancient sites were observed. The representation of historical events and ancient ruins and architecture, just like its landscape, were obvious. That's already a brilliant observation. Here is another question. Which part of the movie reminds you of something? What is it and why? You answered that in the movie clip, The Helen of Troy, the part where the soldiers gathered around in one place. It reminded you of some historical artworks that you always see in museums, such as paintings, sculpture, and more. While in the movie clip, The Fall of Roman Empire, it is the part where the characters are gathering in a landscape. For you, the movie clip shows romantic adoration of nature. That's really good. After watching the movie clips and answering the questions, most of you answered about the Greek and Roman historical events, its architecture, and what it depicts. You are able to witness the different landscapes in every scene. Now, you have unlocked the door going to the arts of Neoclassicism and Romanticism period museum. You will now receive your entry tickets. Then, we will discuss to you the Neoclassic and Romantic periods, characteristics, and representative artist works. As you enter the museum, you will be able to recognize the background of the art, interpret the meanings and emotions of the selected artworks in your classic and romantic periods in terms of art movement, discuss the elements and principles applied in the artworks of the selected artist, give respect to others' insights about the importance of art in your classic and romantic periods through constructive feedback, and show appreciation for the artistic talents of the selected artists of the Neoclassic and Romantic arts by sharing its influence. Being your tour guide, we're going to walk you through this museum. But first, let's have an activity called Neo Room Tour. And I'll pass you through to your next tour guide, Teacher Glenda.
Hello students, in this tour, we are going to have an activity and it's called Neo Room Tour. You're going to have a time travel tour in Neoclassicism and Romanticism. Your first stop is the nature and background from its art movements, art styles, and themes. Neoclassicism's art style and themes. The word neoclassic comes from the Greek word neos, meaning new, and the Latin word classicus, which is similar in meaning to the English phrase first class. The name is given to Western movements in the decorative and visual arts, literature, theater, music, and architecture that draw inspiration from the classical art and culture of ancient Greece or ancient Rome. The main neoclassical movement, remember this one, coincided with the 18th century Age of Reason or Age of Enlightenment. This one as well. The art style was brought about by the renewed interest for Greek and Roman classics. Neoclassical art pieces generally portrayed Roman history and they elevated the Roman heroes. Let's now talk about Romanticism's art styles and themes. Romanticism is a movement in which the artists of the Neoclassical period sought to break new ground in the expression of emotion, both subtle and stormy. It embraced a number of distinctive themes, such as longing for history, supernatural elements, social injustices, and nature. Landscape painting became more popular due to the people's romantic adoration of nature. It is a reaction to the classical, contemplative nature of neoclassical pieces. Now, your next destination would be the sample artworks of both periods we mentioned earlier, the Neoclassic and Romantic periods, through this video presentation we made just for you. Be ready, because after watching the video, we will give you another question. Hello and welcome to your second destination. Congratulations, by the way. And in here, you shall be able to see different sample artworks of the Neoclassicism and Romanticism period.
The sample artworks of Neoclassicism period. First is the Death of Marat. Jacques-Louis David painted The Death of Marat in 1793, depicting the assassinated French revolutionary leader Jean-Paul Marat. One of the most well-known photographs from the French Revolution is this one. Next up is The Intervention of the Sabine Women by Jacques-Louis David. After a period of civil strife that culminated in the Reign of Terror and the Thermidorian Reaction, during which David was imprisoned as a supporter of Robespierre, France was at war with other European nations. Lastly, The Coronation of Napoleon. The work depicts the coronation of Napoleon and his wife Giuseppina Beauharnais. Napoleon is depicted in the center of the painting at the moment of his coronation in front of 80 recognizable characters. Moving on to the sample artworks of Romanticism period. First up is Achilles receiving the envoys of Agamemnon by Ancre, 1801. Ancre, though firmly committed to neoclassical values, is seen as expressing the romantic spirit of the times. Next is The Heywane by John Constable, 1821. Constable was a popular English romantic painter. Lastly, The Oxbow by Thomas Cole, 1836. Thomas Cole was a founding member of the pioneering Hudson School, the most influential landscape art movement in 19th century America. Thank you for watching and staying.
Did you enjoy watching the video presentation? I hear yeses, alright. Now I have here a question. Based on the pictures that you have seen from the video, what art movements, themes, and art style are present? I repeat, based on the pictures that you have seen from the video, what art movements, themes, and art style are present? Alright, based on the pictures that you have seen from the teacher-made video, you were able to observe that the pictures have the art style that was brought about by the renewed interest for Greek and Roman classics. Distinctive themes were present, like depiction of history. Other pictures are with supernatural elements, social injustices, and other pictures portray nature. Thank you, class, for the attentiveness. Keep doing so, because it will lead you to more learnings ahead. You were able to recognize the background of the arts in Neoclassic and Romantic periods. To summarize the art movements of each period, the art style of Neoclassicism is an aesthetic attitude based on the art of Greece and Rome in antiquity, which invokes harmony, clarity, restraint, universality, and idealism. It was a Western cultural movement in the decorative and visual arts, literature, theater, music, and architecture that drew inspiration from the art and culture of classical antiquity. On the other hand, the art style of Romanticism was characterized by its emphasis on emotion and individualism, idealization of nature, suspicion of science and industrialization, and glorification. You can already see how vast and far-reaching the Neoclassic and Romantic period was. Despite the wide range of unique expressions fostered by both periods, there were a few fundamental Neoclassic and Romantic descriptions that underpin their respective arts. Now, how will you be able to analyze the selected art pieces in Neoclassicism and Romanticism? Let us go to the museum's hallway to find out. I'll pass you through to our next tour guide, Teacher Angelique.
So class, we are here in our museum's hallway. I will show you two pictures of artworks from the art movement under new classicism. Draw August Dominique Ombra and Eugene Delacroix of Romanticism. After you observe the paintings, I will be asking another set of questions. Be ready and be observant. Here is a painting from New Classicism from Draw August Dominique Ombra, 1780-1867, The Apotheosis of Homer. Now, The Apotheosis of Homer is a grand 1827 painting by Draw August Dominique Ombra. This symbolizes the symmetrical composition depicts Homer being crowned by a winged figure personifying victory or the universe. Now, here's a painting from Romanticism from Eugene Delacroix, 1854, Christ on the Sea of Galilee. Now, this picture is based on an episode described in the three New Testament Gospels. A violent storm breaks out as Jesus and his followers sail across the Sea of Galilee to proclaim Christ's message. To the astonishment of the disciples, Jesus calms the wind and storm, demonstrating the power of Christian faith. After observing and knowing the hidden meanings of the paintings, I have here some questions. Now, why do you think these artworks were created by the artists during the New Classic and Romantic period? How are you able to analyze the artist's purpose based on the art movement? Okay, for you, those artworks were made for many reasons. Artists may be inspired by the happenings around or from the experiences that prompt them to do so. No? As for the artworks shown, they wanted to depict a message about the historical happenings, hence both artworks display an old features. Well, that's already a good point. So here's the other question. Why is it important to examine these artworks? How are you able to recognize it? Alright! You were really observing and listening. By looking at a work of art symbolism, you learn about the art movement of the artworks and its underlying meaning. As shown, you recognize the artist's influence. As it was stated earlier that New Classicism displays about Roman history, elevated Roman heroes, and it clearly displays as what the example picture illustrates. Same goes for Romanticism, which embraces longing for history, nature, and other distinctive things. Kudos to that idea you have! You were able to analyze selected art pieces of New Classic and Romantic periods in terms of its art movements, such as the theme and its art styles. The artists in these art movements clearly depicts the different historical backgrounds. Put in mind the significance of these artworks and how these artists brought life in their piece. Both Neoclassicism and Romanticism artists like Ombra and Delacroix took much meaning and influence. Now, what are the principles, the elements, and characteristics? To explicit your knowledge, let's explore our arts of Neoclassical and Romantic period, Museum's Chambers. Welcome to this chamber of our museum. As you enter, I have a question. Based on your previous learning experience, give an example of an artwork and identify its elements and principles. Alright, an example of an artwork that you gave is the painting of Leonardo da Vinci, Mona Lisa. Well, with a mystic smile and the most beautiful hand ever painted. Yes, the color is warm and the rhythm is there because of the repeated elements. The line, the shape, the texture, and the balance of the artwork. Well, that's already a good example. Thank you for that idea. You were able to recall the elements of arts such as lines that are defined by a point moving in space. It may be two or three-dimensional, descriptive or implied or abstract. Shape is an element of art that is two-dimensional, flat or limited to height and width. Texture refers to the way things feel or look as if they might feel if touched. And color is an element of art made up of three properties, the who, value, and intensity. While the principles of arts are balance, it is a way of combining elements to add a feeling of equilibrium or stability to a work of art. Emphasis is a way of combining elements to stress the differences between those elements. Movement is used to create the look and feeling of action and to guide the viewer's eyes throughout the work of art. Proportion refers to the relationship of certain elements to the whole, to each other. Rhythm indicates movement created by the careful placement of elements in a work of art to cause a visual tempo or beat. Well, unity combines similar elements in an artwork to accent their similarities, achieved through use of repetitions and subtle gradual changes, and variety, which concerns with diversity or contrast. It is achieved by using different shapes, sizes, and colors in a work of art. Now it's time for you to view the paintings from the selected artist and dig deeper about the elements and principles of arts. Still, we will be going to ask you questions of what you have observed from the paintings that we will show to you. Now, here is the famous artwork from Neoclassicism, The Apotheosis of Homer by Jean-Augustin Dominique Honoré. And here is another famous artwork from Romanticism, The Christ on the Sea of Galilee, 1854 by Eugène Delacroix. Okay, are you ready? Now here are the questions. What are the dominating elements of art found in the painting? Okay, for you, the dominating elements of art found in the painting of Ambra, The Apotheosis of Homer, is that the texture is smooth and there is no brush strokes that can be seen, and the lines are in linear style. Yes, the colors are in different hues and values. While in the painting of the Delacroix, Christ on the Sea of Galilee, the texture is that the brush strokes are visible, yes, and it is done in painterly style. I can see that the line intensity colors that made the painting look dull. Well, that's a nice point of view. Keep it up. Now here's another. Give an example of an existing principle that is visible in the painting. Okay, what a great observer. You were able to notice that there are similar elements combined. Okay, some existing principles of design in the painting of Ambra, The Apotheosis of Homer, are emphasis and variety because there are different shapes and colors in the work of art. Yes, on the painting of the Delacroix, Christ on the Sea of Galilee, the principles that we're seeing are the following. Nature is defined as a natural environment, just like having the sea, wherein it talks about the principle of rhythm. That's a good example. Kudos to you. Elements and principles of arts are essential in the creation of art. Arts elements are the building blocks of visual tools used to create composition, such as a line, shape, texture, and color. Principles of art, on the other hand, are the used to organize the elements of art, such as balance, emphasis, movement, proportion, unity, variety, and rhythm. Based on the given paintings from the representative artists in each period, you were able to discuss the elements and principles applied in the artworks of the selected artists of the Neoclassic and Romantic periods. Yes, we are done in the elements and principles chamber. Now let's venture to another chamber of this Arts of Neoclassical and Romantic Period Museum. There are still rooms of learning for you to identify the distinct characteristics of arts present in this period. I'll pass you through to your next tour guide, Teacher Alba.
Welcome to the Characteristics of Arts Chamber. We will be showing you an animation video about the overview of the characteristics of arts in both Neoclassic and Romantic periods. After which, another activity will welcome you. So please pay close attention as you gather another learning from this tour. Characteristics of Neoclassicism art reflects and depicts Roman history. It employs classic geostructures, uses formal composition, diagonals that express the pinnacles of emotions and movements, and they use local color. It resulted in a widespread rebirth of the classical thinking, which reflected what were going on in the political and social arena during that time, which eventually culminating the French Revolution. The principles of simplicity, symmetry, and mathematics were regarded as the virtues of arts in ancient Greece and Rome, which guided the neoclassical art. The characteristics of Romanticism arts depicts the height of action, emotional extremes, depicts nature as out of control, uses dramatic composition, and delivers heightened sensation such as life and death situations. Artists during this period painted subjects that were diametrically opposed to the rigid decorum and classical, historical, and mythical subject matter of the traditional figurative art. These painters preferred weird, tragic, and extravagantly heroic themes, and they characterize their works with tensely linear drawings and striking contrast of light and shadows. So here's your activity. You will segregate one by one the characteristics into their designated works of the artist.
Okay, let me check your answers. As we can see, you have here the Neoclassicism art's characteristics. Number 1, brought back and depicted Roman history. Number 2, uses formal composition. Number 3, the use of diagonal shows the apex of emotions or moments. Number 4, uses local color. And number 5, classic geostructure. Now for the Romanticism art's characteristics, we have number 1, shows the height of action. Number 2, emotional extremes. Number 3, celebrated nature as out of control. Number 4, dramatic compositions. And number 5, heightened sensation such as life and death moments.
Wow, you were able to segregate the characteristics into the right paintings. Continue doing well. Now that we are able to explore the chambers from elements and principles down to the characteristics of arts. Now we're almost done with our tour in this museum. But for you to be able to have your exit ticket, you need to give respect to others' insight about the importance of arts through constructive feedback. And show appreciation for the artistic talents in the selected artist by sharing its influence. So now it's your turn to apply and share what you've learned in this tour. Now I'll be handing you over to our next tour guide, Teacher Mark John.
Are you enjoying our tour for today? From different chambers and hallways, now you have arrived at the end of the museum. But before anything else, I have your questions that you need to answer for you to get the exit ticket. And after the other student answer the question, you are going to give your feedback whether you agree or disagree with his or her answer. So now, here is the question. As a youth of today, why do you think the arts of neoclassic and romantic periods are important? Okay, you have a nice idea. You think that this age of reason and enlightenment brought a great importance to today, especially for its visual arts. Both neoclassicism and romanticism periods create together to express emotion as well as love to the classics. Now, does anybody here agree with his statement? Alright, you agree with his statement. In addition to that, these two periods were influenced by many artists because of their beautiful and fine details. The importance of these periods shows a wide range of culture and influence on the evolution of art. Here's the second question. From the selected artists being discussed, whose artwork inspires you to appreciate the arts of neoclassic and romantic periods? And why? Right, that's an expensive answer. You were inspired by the artwork of Eugene Delacroix, Christ on the Sea of the Gallery. Because aside from his historical background, his artwork portrays mythical subject matter. Moreover, the way he paints is full of passion, and you can see his own expression towards what is happening. Now, does anybody here agree with his answer? Alright, you agree because through his artwork, you were able to express your own viewpoints. You said that there are other meanings you cannot distinguish right away, but through knowing the purpose of the artist, you were able to grasp his ideas. We could see how much appreciation you've shown based on stating the influence you got from our discussion. Those ideas in your mind made the importance of arts exist. So, as we are going to end our tour today, you were able to recognize the background of arts, interpret the meaning and emotions of the selected artworks from neoclassic and romantic periods in terms of art movement, discuss the elements and principles applied in the artworks from the selected artists, give respect to others' insight about the importance of arts in neoclassic and romantic periods through constructive feedback, and show appreciation to the artistic talent of the selected artists from neoclassic and romantic periods through sharing its influence.
Art is truly amazing and useful. It allows us to see a new perspective on our world, expresses our emotions, and depicts reality.
We can identify the importance of arts through its characteristics by analyzing how it reflects and how it is used in an artwork.
You'll do a great job. Because of that, you will receive rewards, and those are your entry tickets.
Now, for our next trip, here is your assignment. You are going to prepare any art materials used for painting, drawing, sculpture, or watercolor. Examples of these are canvas, paintbrush, acrylic paint, oil paint, Oslo papers, clay, soap bars, crayons, pencil, and cutter. Now, be ready because another trip means another learning.
As we are on the last part of our venture today, we would like to impart to you a quote. In the arts, the way in which an idea is rendered and the manner in which it is expressed is much more important than the idea itself, by Jacques Louis David. So art is not merely about what our naked eyes can see, but how it portrays the ideas and the story it tells.
Just like how both periods convey their purpose towards their arts.
Both Neoclassicism and Romanticism were eras of wisdom and enlightenment.
Many contemporary artists have been affected because of their fine details and elaborative drama.
We hope that you will keep exploring these fascinating timelines on your own. This has been Teacher Alba,
Teacher Angelou,
Teacher Glenda,
Teacher Jay,
Teacher Mark Jan. Thank you, and once again, have a good day.